Those are what's preventing the turntable from exploding. I can say that I successfully wasted 2 days of my life doing nothing. Finally, here's a bunch of problems. These Decora-style light switches. They're like $100, so I decided to make my own out of $200 in Lego parts. Let alone 5, which could happen during the death mode multi-ball. Pretty simple, right?
Nope.
What have I been doing during that while, you may ask? Just look at this thing, in all of its glory. It's all compact and stuff. Do not fear though, longer ones exist. The answer is that there really is no point. I just wanted to waste 4 minutes of your time, and you're never gonna get that 4 minutes back. But hold your horses. That's right, it's time for some quick maths. And for all I know, this could be magic. I don't even understand why this happens. You know what, it's Halloween. It's probably a ghost, or some witches. Yeah, that sounds about right, it's because of witches. The red one is responsible for dropping balls. Well, watch this. I was originally gonna push the lever with one of those cringe cat pot toys that apparently you can find at Hot Topic. And since quarters are thick boys, they'll just slide right on over it. I wanted them to unwind slowly. So everyone knows what a turntable is, right? It's a table that turns. The separated individual bricks are then pushed above a bunch of holes. So I just made a spinny thing that slaps the ball away if it comes near it. Monkey see, monkey do, and monkey did. Separator lever activator, separator lever activator, separator lever activator, separator lever activator, separator lever activator. Maybe just build up from the ground? For 6 clicks.
On a bit more of a personal note, projects like these kind of destroy my soul.
If both of them are hit, it triggers something that I like to call
death mode.
But how exactly do you stick Lego to a light switch? I'm not trying to toot my own horn with my superior measuring skills, but, you know. So with one of these, I suppose you could give your Lego creations epic 360 views. Then you know that they churn through batteries like crazy. It will also prevent you from increasing the amount of cards if the product of cards and players is greater than 52. It's known as a push-push switch. Oh, hello. I then proceeded to open the bags they came in with my half-horsepower Lego table saw. If you don't insert a quarter, you can spin it all you want, but nothing will happen. The piece that does the actual pushing is the white one that's bobbing up and down right now, and the face on it makes it even funnier. So I woke up a few days ago and I was like, hey, I know what I want to do today. I want to make a 1 to 100 Google Gear ratio out of Lego. And so I did. And I know there's gonna be people out there who are gonna say,
well, Lego Mindstorms has voltage regulators in it.
If the input voltage is too high, they're gonna be dissipating more power than they should be and overheat. The program for this thing is actually pretty simple. It's actually not that bad. This top loop controls the motors, this second loop is the GUI and sets the card and player count, and all this third loop does is continuously refresh the LCD. Have you ever taken apart a Lego creation, sorted the parts into piles, and ended up with this? Well, have I got the solution for you. It's the Lego Gear Sorter 3000, or whatever cringe-worthy name you want to call it. And it even has a sorting accuracy of 69.69%.